Welcome back, everybody. Today, what you see in front of you is what we're going to be working on today. We're going to create a super simple cyborg head inside ZBrush. We'll take it over into Substance Painter and then do a final render inside Marmoset. Now, I say it, you know, it doesn't necessarily look simple. But really, in actuality, it really is not that hard, and I'm going to go through all the steps to get you there. Modeling part is not going to be too difficult. The back part of the cyborg head and then the, I don't know, earmuffs, whatever, the sensors or whatever on the side of his head are all using the Greebles that we're going to use the Greeble generator to help generate that, and then we'll create a actual smart material inside Substance Painter that you can reuse over and over and over again. It'll have height, it'll have roughness, it'll have emission, even opacity built into it. So you can use it on any model that you send over there. It's just a matter of just drag and drop, and you can add it to all your designs quickly and easily. So without further ado, let's we're going to go into ZBrush, and we're going to get started today. Hop over into ZBrush here. Let's go ahead and create our Greebles real quick. We only need to create one, but we need to create all the maps to make all the materials and everything. So you need to open up, go into your Greeble Pro Pack, Greeble Generator, version 1.1. Everyone should have that. Give it a second to load up. And then I'm not going to go into details on how to use it. I've done that in a couple other videos here. So just watch me real quick to go through this thing pretty quickly to create a material here. So we just need to be in our NanoMesh panel. We're going to hop over to the tech panels. I'm going to just give it a quick random seed. Want to find something that where I got a little bit of background, a little bit of foreground, and some of the pipes in between. Really always seems to make a good material. And increase the size just a little bit. And let's go over to our miscellaneous. Just going to do another random seed on him. Maybe increase the size just a little bit. Lots of different options to play with. But you can see how quickly and easily we're able to make all this. Okay. Let's see. Let's open up the pipes. And I'm going to random seed him. There are a lot of other variations that you can do. I'm going to go to each index here and change them all. That guy is existing behind everybody there, so I need to bring him out just a little bit there. He's a little too far out there. That'll work. Another random seed. Okay, let's go over to Conduit. I'm going to just random seed him real fast. This is probably the conduits that I'm going to end up making an emission channel off of. If I can get them lined up to where I like it. And give them a little more random distribution here so we get a couple more in here. Okay, I think I'm going to be okay with that. So all you have to do is I'm going to bring my macro panel over to the right side here so I can open up my macros and Greeble texture passes, and then I'm going to open up my textures at the same time so I can see it auto-populate there, and then go ahead and activate it. And it's going to start running through the ZScript operation. As you can see, it's already laid out the depth. And that's going to come in a extremely handy when we take it into Marmoset and do our displacement. And now it's going to generate 6 more textures for you. So I'm going to go ahead and pause the video. It'll take a second for you, it'll take about a few minutes for me. So I'm going to pause it and wait till the ZScript finishes, and I'll be right back. Okay, we are done. The ZScript is done producing all the maps we need. Once you see this little message here, everything is finished. And if you look over here, we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 different maps in there, just like before. As you can see, we got a depth, we got a material ID, we have a curvature, we have a normal, we have an AO, diffuse, and then a shaded. And as you remember, they are all tileable. So we can decrease the size of the map, or we can tile the map without any visible seams, which is going to come in very handy here once we get into Substance Painter. So let's go ahead and just click on each of these real quick. We're going to save them off. And we're going to, let's see where I want to put these guys. And call it Greeble, because that's what it is. And then I'm just going to change them to TIFFs for the time being. You get the best bit rate, and you don't lose any details because of compression. So I'm just going to save them off as TIFF. So you just go to each one, export it. Once you tell it it's a TIFF, it'll just remember that. And everything's named, so it's just pretty quick and easy. Just click on each one, export, and you're good to go. So just make sure you export them all out, because they'll all come in a little bit handy in the future. Alright, so we got all those guys tucked away there. I'm going to close the panel up there, close up my nanomesh, close up my macro, and you can go ahead and just do initialize. You don't have to, but this way you get more screen space here. And usually you got to do it twice, just so it fixes the background color. There you go. Now you got the gradient back. Alright, so let me switch over to basic material. And we're going to use two different primitives to get us started. And the reason I like using primitives is the way it wraps the UVs and uses the most texture space on them. And I'll show you here in just a second. So let's go ahead and start with those earmuffs or headphones or whatever you want to call them. We're going to start with Sphere 3D, and this is one of ZBrush's primitives, T for edit. We want to initialize it. We don't need this much geometry. First align them on X. There you go. This way the poles are on the left and right side. And let's go ahead and change the H divide to 32. V divide, I think 24 should do us. Yeah, that looks good. Alright, now go ahead and make Polymesh 3D. And you can tap your X, and now you get X symmetry. And we're going to go to Z Modeler. The shortcut is BZM. And Z Modeler, I got it down here in my UI. I'll give you guys a link for my UI. I'll try to go into the menus and use them so you see where I'm going, but sometimes I accidentally tap my UI, so it's just force of habit. Definitely set one up for yourself. It's going to make your life so much easier. So let's go ahead and I just want to create a polygroup here. First, I want to show you real quick. If you go into your UV map, because primitives already have UVs, so if you hit Morph UV in your UV map, morph it. Now you can see how your UV map is. And that's your UV map right there. So it's already mapped correctly. So this way you can make something symmetrical. Or you can make it tileable. It'll wrap perfectly around each other. So you won't really see a visible seam. So that's why I like using these primitives to get going. Let's see. So I showed you that. And go ahead, polygroup, polyloop, and we're just going to change that middle one there, okay, just so it's easier to capture there. And then let's see, I think I want to do an inflate polygroup ball. And let's see if this works. Yeah, this is going to work just like that. Okay. That inflated him or deflated him nicely. And let's see, we want to get the left and right side out a little bit further, so it's on either side of the head when we make the head. So let's go ahead and do a move. Take your, let me see if I can do this with symmetry on. Probably not. Nope. Okay. First, we want to, let me isolate him. I'm gonna throw a mask on him. Oh, he's gonna be a pain. Okay. And now put a mask on him. See if he lets me move him now. Had this figured out yesterday, but now I've. Yeah, this will work. So if you hold shift, that'll constrain it there. Don't worry about it kind of bubbling out there. We'll fix that here in a second. So reverse the mask. And then now we should be able to. Oops, just do it like that. Just going to flatten it out there. All right, like that. Boom. Okay. Now we got a little barbell. But that's going to be our headphones, basically. Let's see here. What do we want to do next? Let's go ahead. We'll come back to him. Let me rename him real quick. We'll just ears, just for sake of speed here on typing. And now let's go ahead and make something else. We want to grab another primitive, a cylinder 3D. Okay. Same situation here. We want to align on the X. Okay. And with this one, I think he's got. I may increase the resolution just a little bit. Maybe not that way, that way. Okay. Let's go ahead and we want to do inner radius. Like that. All right. And let's go ahead and make Polymesh 3D. Go back to our ears. Let's do go into your subtool. And you want to do append. Find that cylinder that we just made. Okay, there we go. Let's go down here and rename them. We'll just put head. Doesn't look like a head at the moment. We'll work on that. I'm going to solo him real fast. We'll go into polygroups. I want to group by normals. Okay. Let me get rid of him. Him. Now we just got the two sides there. And if you go, you've still got your polygroups open, you can group visible. And so we can see him better, let's go to display properties and click double. I've got this in my UI, so I'm going to use that from now on. So this way we can see both sides of the normal. And control shift and close him back up. Now we've got some polygroups to isolate things. We can take him out of solo. Let's go ahead and do just a little scale. Tap X, so we got symmetry on him. Alright, so see if I can just bring him out like that. There we go. Alright, so let's go ahead. Let's go ahead and see if we can make a shape here. If you go under to-do-do-do, brush. And there's an auto masking feature in here. It's a mask by polygroups. Okay, I've got him in my UI up here. And let's go over to move. And so every poly, you know, so if we click on this polygroup here, let me increase the scale a little bit. The only thing that's really going to move is that green right there. The only reason that purple is going with it is because it's attached to it, and we don't have any extra geometry to support it. So Control Z. What we may do is isolate him, mask him, bring everybody back, reverse the mask, and we can probably do it this way. And see, it still does it as if it's even with its mask. So I'm gonna increase the size a bit. So we're gonna make our shape here. Pointed the right way. So we're just gonna make a basic humanoid head shape here. Yeah, I know, we're not there yet. So we'll use some smooth in here in a second to kind of fix some of this. Look at the front of him here. Maybe bring him out just a little bit. Bring him in. We're just trying to get the basic silhouette of a human head. Now, if you hold down shift, you can change your Z intensity down. It'll get down to about 10 or 13, something like that. Just because we got so few polygons right now. We don't want to smooth too crazily. So you can even load up, or not load up, but you can do deformations, you do by groups here, or by features. That'll kind of help things out, smooth everything out. Let me take the mask off. Polish by groups tends to help quite a bit. Maybe decrease the size, maybe get rid of some of this sharpness up here and repeat it. Can even do just a basic smooth. So we still got the move on here. Kind of fix our shape a little bit. Could be, it doesn't have to be perfectly humanoid proportions here. It's a cyborg. It could be whatever shape we want it to be. Position some things here. All right, I'm happy with that. Now, the same thing, since we're using a primitive on him, and let me solo him out so you can see what he does here. Let me close this panel up here. And this is that Morph UV again. You can see how he's laid out. So he's wrapped around each other. So he shares a lot of the UV space. But he wraps symmetrically. So where one side begins, the other one starts. And we'll be using the greebles on it, which are tileable. So you won't see any visible seam. And that's what we want. So take him off a solo there. And that little gap right there, I'm not overly worried about because once we get into Marmoset, we'll be using a displacement and that will fill in the void. So, okay, so we got him and their UVs are already set up, so we don't even have to worry about them. So let's go back to our subtool and I want to make a duplicate of the head because we're going to make a faceplate. And then I'm just going to move him to the bottom, rename him. So, face plate. Alright. Definitely get into a habit of naming things. It's going to help. It's going to make your life so much easier. Trust me. And let's see. So, we've got a duplicate of him. What I want to do with him is I want to delete that part there. Delete hidden, which is in your close him up, geometry, modified topology, and you can delete hidden. Okay. I'm not overly concerned about topology at the moment, because we're going to get our initial design down here. I'm going to go back to ZModeler real quick. I'm going to close up that hole. Just change it to convex. And add a little bit there. It's fine. We'll just group visible. I don't need any polygroups at this second. Let me frame him up. We're going to divide him up a bit. It's going to smooth him out. That's fine. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to use, I'm going to delete lower here. I'm going to turn the lines off there. We'll still see the polygroup fill color, which is fine, which is what we're going to really want. I want you to do B, S, and then slice curve, okay, which is I on the last part there. I've got it down here in my UI. And we're going to start cutting out our parts of the faceplate. So let me turn solo off here and transparency so I can see where everybody's at here. I'm actually going to go to deformation. I'm going to inflate because I want him to exist above that stuff we already created. Maybe a little bit more. There we go. That's fine. And we'll just smooth him out there. Do that a couple times. Okay. So let's go ahead and start slicing this guy up. So you can see our headphones right here, headphone ears. And actually, I want you to do B, S, circle instead. Alright. So, and then if you do Control Shift, sometimes you have to do it twice to get it to work right. Hold it down and go into your circle here, and then hit Square. What that's going to do is it's going to make a perfect circle for you. And then you can use the space bar to align it. I may make him a lot larger because I want to be able to see all the greeples underneath him. But I want to get him just about center there. Do that. Boom. Now it's cut a perfect line in there. That's what we want. So let's go ahead and I'm just going to isolate him. And now we're going to start slicing him up with a slice curve. So, okay. So now we're all ready to go here. So it doesn't really matter which side that little gray line is. It doesn't really matter. But what does matter is, what I gotta do is this, so it doesn't make a cut down below where I don't want it. There we go. Slice it like that. And then all I'm doing is tapping Alt twice real fast, and that'll make a sharp curve. So let's go to the front of the face here. We'll make a couple large breaks in here. So if you do B, S for slice, and then E for rectangle, that will make a rectangular slice now. So we're going to make a nice little slice here. Okay. Isolate the blue again here, so we just got the blue, because that's who's going to end up staying here. Let's make a small slit down here. Doesn't matter that it's not symmetrical at the moment, I'll fix that here in a minute. And do that. Oh. See if it gives me a better color this time. There we go. Now I can see it. If you just click on him, get him out of there. And now we can go to our regular slice curve and we can make some nice slices here. Actually, we don't want to do that just yet. What I want to do is, let's do B slice rectangle. There we go. I'm going to put one right about There, okay. So unhide everybody and just do mirror and weld, which is in your geometry. Right there. And then make sure it's on the X. And then boom. There we go. It fixes that, makes it symmetrical now. All right, so looks like I got to get rid of one more piece here. And maybe do something a little different this time. Let me do B slice and find that circle again, C. And we're gonna cut it right there. Okay. So let's take a look here. Let me hit solo, see how this guy looks. That looks pretty cool. So the ones we want to get rid of is this one. Get rid of him. 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 That one. And that one. There we go. These are the only things that I want to keep. So let's go ahead and we're going to do a delete hidden. Okay, everything's deleted. Now we're going to do inside our geometry here, we're going to do a Z remesh. We're going to keep groups. And we'll just keep the defaults. Just make sure that keep groups is on. And Z remesh. As long as you have X symmetry on, it'll make it perfect. So we can hit line there. Now we can see that it's perfectly symmetrical. It's still a little heavy on topology at the moment. That's all right. We'll fix that. So if you hit half, it's going to start doing half the topology each time. Things tend to get a little rounded, but that's okay. That's an okay look for us. We're going to do it one more time. All right, so that's about 1100. 1100 active points there. That's good. That's going to be good for taking it into Marmoset. It can handle that easily. All right, so let's go ahead and we're gonna do a little Z model in here. I just want to do, I think just the inflate will work just fine, but we want to change it to poly loop and make sure you're pointing in the right direction. You can see that little orange arrow there. We want it to point left to right, so it just affects that one. And we're gonna get the eye section in there. And let's see, let's try a slide on edge action, edge loop complete. Let's see what happens when I slide this guy up, see how he looks. There we go. Now I got the eyes set up there. Let's go ahead and do another polygon action. We're going to do inset, single poly. Make sure it's set to region because we're going to select multiple polys here. Let me look at him dead on here. Kind of figure out where I want to place the eyes. And hold down Alt and then select your eyes that you want. And go one more in. There we go. Okay. And now you can select on it and create that. Let me Alt that. So. There we go. Now we got our eyes set up there. Now we got to get a little depth to our plate here, which is not too hard to do. You can actually go on the inside here and do a Q mesh and then all polys. And then you can add depth to it on the inside of it. The only thing you got to watch out for, let me take double off and you'll see what happens. All our normals are the wrong way. And that was because of the Q mesh operation or an extrude operation to do the same thing. Because we went against the normal. Because the normal were on the backside of the polygon when we created it. So it made everything basically inside out. easy fix. You can do it with the Z modeler. All you gotta do is find flip faces and just do all polygons, since they're all flip the wrong way, and just click it. Bam, it's fixed. There you go. Not any problem. Easy peasy. All right, so let's go ahead and I want to go back to my eyes here real quick. We're gonna do just a Q mesh. No, don't do Q mesh. Do extrude, because I don't want to snap to anything. Single poly. Actually, you could do poly group actually, because it's its own little poly group there. We'll go in till we just poke through. It's there somewhere. Well, we'll just do it about right there. That's fine. So now, do switch it over to a delete, single poly. I'm going to turn my back face mask on so I don't accidentally select something behind it. Hold down Alt, select all of these, turn it around, find the same topology back here. You can try to do it with a Q mesh operation. Sometimes it'll snap to it correctly, sometimes it won't, so that's why I'm doing it this way. So I deleted that. Whoa, where's it at? Yeah, there we go. We can see it now. Okay. So, and then just do a quick edge action. You want to go ahead and close. Let's see. Actually, bridge, two holes. And then click that edge. Click that edge. Okay. Oop. Let me control Z that. Click, let me polygroup flat. There we go. Now I got a unique ID that I can see there. See, and it did it to the other side. Good. Good. Alright, so let's go ahead. And that little polygroup there is going to come in pretty handy later. I'll show you. So there's our basic design for our helmet. Or our faceplate in this case. Turn solo off, transparency off. So we need to bring him out. Let's go ahead and just do a move. We just need to pull him away from the model just a little bit. I always forget to turn mask by polygroup off. Move him out. Okay. Like I said, we want him away from the model. And I may just stretch him out just ever so slightly. Because as you can see, he kind of dips in there. Actually, you could do it with a move, actually. Let me recenter everything. That's not working. Let's just go to deformation size. We'll do X. There we go. Not too bad, not too bad. I'm okay with that. Alrighty, so what to do next here? Alright, so let's go. We've basically got the basics of everything right now. So let me go back to, let's go back to him here. We'll do a little bit more with him, just a little bit. The one thing to note, when you're messing with primitives and stuff like that, and they've already got the UV set up, and you're using Z Modeler, don't ever add edge loops. Don't ever extrude, Q mesh, inset. Either that, or you'll have to remap everything. It destroys the UVs in that particular region you're working on. So, just a little food for thought there. So that's why I'm kind of doing things the way I am with the primitives, because I don't want to mess up the UVs. So here's some tricks to show you real quick. Say like I want to put like a little I don't know, I guess a bevel or basically kind of doing a Q mesh function but a little differently without using Q mesh. So do I'm gonna do a polygroup real quick. And do I got it poly loop. Nope, there we go. So we're going to go ahead and do set up on delete. I want poly group. There we go. We're going to set him up and point that way. Change it. There we go. Let's see. So now do a slide operation with your edge loop again. We're going to slide him all the way over. And slide this one all the way over. So now he's got topology to where I can push that one group in. Now you can do inflate, polygroup, and there you go. And you haven't messed with any of the UVs, so they're still intact. You just kind of slid some things around. So what I'm going to do right now, while I'm thinking about it, I'm going to crease some edges. So edge loop complete on the crease, so we're going to crease him. So this way I can make some high-res models to export out. And right now, it's not mirrored at all. Physically it looks mirrored, but the texture map isn't mirrored. So what you want to do, so this way the left side looks like the right side, just go to Geometry and click, go into your Modify. You just need to do a mirror and weld. There you go. Once you get that little line in there, you'll know that you're pretty much mirrored and weld now. So whenever a texture is applied, it'll be the same on both sides. And we need to do that with the head model. There we go. And since I'm still set up on creasing, I will do that too. So I'm going to crease him right there. Because I just need to protect that little edge right there. And then same thing in mirror and weld. He's mirror and welded now. So the same thing will be happening here. You'll get that symmetrical look on both sides when we apply our maps in Substance Painter. All right, so let's go to our faceplate here. We're going to go ahead and give some creasing to these guys here. And we need to go in and set up our UVs for him. This would be the only thing that we have to set up UVs for. And he's pretty simple, really. And let me just do a crease polygroup. That'll help me out there. And I can check it, see how that creasing's holding. Good. That's going to be perfect. It's going to be quite nice when it's ready. All right, cool. Let's see. Let's go ahead and get set up for unwrap here. So we're going to do it by polygroups like I've shown in the past. So let's get some of our polygroups together here. You can open up the polygroup panel, and you can do group visible. And I've got it right here, so I'll just use that from now on. I want to get the outside all together, and then the inside all together. Group visible, okay. Double him so I can see the inside again. Okay. Let's see. I want to get the outside edge and the inside here together. Auto group him real fast. Alright, so fix them. So I need to do this. Yeah, that's fine. What I'm trying to do is I'm trying to make this little purple one its own individual island. Group visible. Okay, gotta get the right side now. Visible, okay. There we go. So now we should have three separate islands. Yeah, that's gonna work just fine. So go ahead and open up Z plugin and UV master. Leave it to symmetrical and polygroups. And go ahead and unwrap. Should only take a few seconds. Alright, four islands were generated. Let's see what the extra island. Oh, I know what it was. It's for the two different eyes. I gotcha. So go to UV map and morph UV, and we'll see what these maps look like. Okay. Let me frame them up there. Yeah, those little guys are real small there. Those little island, the around the edge of the eye. But the only thing I want to do with them is give them an emission channel, which is fine. It doesn't need to be super big. It's just going to be a very small thing there. But what I do want to do is give the outside one more texture space than the inside. And because you're only going to really see the outside, so there's no sense in giving the inside so much texture space. So go back to your UV master, enable control painting, and switch over to density. The material will change real fast, and it'll automatically go to density 2. And if you go to do color fill object, will fill the whole thing real fast. And then go to that backside, select just him, the back of it, which we're not going to see, and switch it over to divide 3. And then do another color fill object. Okay, now unhide everything. Now the outside's got a different one than the inside, and watch what happens. So unwrap again, and now morph UV. As you can see, our outside one has got the most texture space. And these little guys, like I said, I'm not too worried about them. They're just going to be emission channels, really. They're pretty small in comparison to the rest of the models, so I'm not worried about them. But that is exactly what we want. So get back out of your morph there, and this guy is set up, and we can go ahead and change back to a basic material. And let me double check, make sure his fill is back to white. Okay, that's good. And turn cello off. There we go, he's ready. So now we've got everybody ready there. So it's probably best that we saved it by now, right? And let's see, do do. Alright, so I saved him. Always save often. I never do that. Always leads to problems, but that's okay. So continuing on here, let's go ahead and we are going to set up the high-res version of this faceplate. So let's go ahead and we want to go ahead and duplicate him. Go back to Subtools and duplicate. And we'll throw him to the bottom there. Keep everything organized here. And we're going to just do faceplate high. So this is going to help us get our material ID and everything. So what I want to do is go ahead and divide him up. Let me solo him out. There we go. And we need to divide up higher. About 152,000 points. That should do us. And now we're going to start slicing and dicing here. So just do your slice curve here, and just start making some cool patterns. You can just do it all on one side. It's fine. Oh, gotta delete the subdivision. Sorry, guys. Delete lower. There we go. Just remember to double tap that. Let's just get the outside. We only really need the outside done, anyways. Alright, so I'll get this straight eventually, guys. zoom in here and take a look. See what we can do up here. Yeah, it'll be all right. So let's go ahead and unhide everything. We'll mirror and weld. Get our patterns on both sides. Looking kind of cool. Should be interesting when we make it. Let's isolate him. Let's slice him up a couple. Okay. Let's see. You don't have to do this, but it gets kind of fun after a while just to put these little panel lines in here. Alright, so what we're going to do now, let me turn a line back on, as you can see where it's done all our slicing. We are going to create a poly loop around all those guys. So let's go to edge loop, turn triangles off. And I think we'll stick with four loops, group loop, G-Polish 50, and see how it looks. Z, let's take the polish down to 20. Zoom in here and see what this looks like. Kind of looks like a hot mess. Let's raise it up to 60. Let's see. There's a couple different ways you could do this. You could actually do panel loops if you wanted to do it that way. I'm doing it by group loops. And so I want you to grab just the loops there. And I want you to make them their own individual polygroup. Okay. So now that that's done, let's go to frame. Everybody's good to go now. Now we can start giving everything a little beveling here. Or not necessarily beveling, but a little extrusion. Here's a good way to do it. Turn your mask by polygroups on. Go to inflate and raise it all the way to 1,000 with the dynamic on. It's a little trick that Pixelogic did. To where if you raise it up to 1,000, it'll do everything equally across the whole tool. So watch. Oops. Obviously, we want to turn the intensity down quite a bit, but it'll do everything equally, as you can see. But because we got mask by polygroup on, it's only doing just that particular polygroup. So now we can raise different ones to different heights. Back out. Pretty cool. Quick, easy way. I think I'm missing a couple up here, aren't I? Yep, I am. And turn polyfill back off. And there we go. Now we've got some really cool panel lines that we can do inside Substance Painter. And everybody is isolated by polygroups, which is going to come in real handy, and I'll show you. So go ahead. It's going to be kind of a weird trick here. So go to your subtools. Go ahead and copy that particular the faceplate high. Go and find Polymesh 3D and just do a paste. And then delete. We're just deleting that top tool. Okay. Alright. So now we got him all isolated by himself. But everything's still the same. Cool. That's what we wanted. So what we have to do is break him apart. And then put him back together again. Break him apart. Decimate him. Put him back together. This way everything will work inside Substance Painter for a material ID. Okay, so let me show you how to do that. It's quick and easy. Just do group split. It's undoable. That's okay. That's why we gave it its own individual, its own tool to play with here, so we didn't destroy the original one that we did. Alright, so we got like 25 subtools, and we need to decimate them all down. You can do that in Decimation Master. Don't have to click on any of that up there. All you gotta do is pre-process all, and it will start cycling through everything and pre-processing all of them. With it only being about 200,000 points, it didn't take long to pre-process. We are gonna do just like a decimation of, just do 6%. It should be fine. So decimate all. So take a look at your total points, 212,081. And we'll take a look at it after it's done. So decimate all and let it cycle through everything. And now we're at 12,711 points. So it did a... I don't know. I may want to fix some of that. Let me... let's raise him up to 15%. See, it's going to be... As you can see, there's a lot of breaks in there. So let me decimate all again. See how that works. Shouldn't take that long. Each one's going to be a little bit, each model will be a little bit different. It's like some of those smaller pieces need to have a little more love than the others. So, let me go ahead and we'll bring it up to 25% decimate. Really, with it being originally 200,000 points, we really didn't even need a decimate, to be honest with you. We just needed to separate it. So that kind of shows you how you can do it. Because the problem we have now is we got little gaps here and there. We don't want all those gaps. So let's go ahead and create a new one here. So we'll go back to Polymesh 3D, and we will just paste again. Okay. And delete. Okay. And so we got this big guy again. He's all together at the moment. We just do a group split. Okay. So you pretty much disregard the decimation process. You really didn't need to do it. Because we have, you know, it's for a high-res poly, it's not that bad. But you still need to split it. So go ahead and we're going to merge everybody back together. So just merge visible. And it throws a merge faceplate up here. And then, so now go back to our original faceplate, which is here. And then all you got to do is append. And merge faceplate. And you can actually just delete that high one now. Delete. Yes, undoable, I know. So merge faceplate and everything is fine. But everything's been separated, so it will work perfectly for us. So let's go ahead and get everybody else set here. I'm going to rename him. Take off that. Okay, faceplate high again. Okay, so he should be intact and ready to go. So let's go up to the head. I want to duplicate him, bring him all the way to the bottom, and rename. I just need to make him, we're going to make a high version. It's not going to be anything fancy with him. Just solo him out. And all we really need to do is just divide him up. Divide till he looks good. That will work. Alright, so let's go up to the ears, or whatever we're calling them. Divide. Oops. We don't want to divide yet. We want to duplicate. And bring him down to the bottom. And go ahead and rename. Name him high. And divide till he looks good. Nice and smooth. Perfect. Alright, so let's go ahead and we're gonna hide all those guys. And I'm just going to do another quick save real fast. I know, I called them ears. That's fine. So, save often. So, we basically have all our components that we need to take over into Substance Painter. And actually, I need to make one more thing. Doesn't really go with any of these. It's just an extra thing that we need to make so we can work inside Substance Painter to make our material. So let's go ahead and make a plain 3D and get to the initialize and then take him down to 2 and 2. Make Polymesh 3D. Okay. Go back to our, there we go. And then subtool. Append. Plain 3D. Okay. And then rename him Rebel Plane. So we can just identify him. Let's go back up top. And we can turn the Rebel Plane off. And then save again. And then we'll export everything out. Okay? Alright, so for starters, we want to save the ears, the head, and the faceplate that we're going to use inside Substance Painter. We're going to export them as FBX. So open that up in your Z plugins. You want to do visible, ASCII, S normals, and options, you want to do export polygroups as S sets. Now export. And alright, we're going to call him just cyborg. Robot, whatever. Alright, so it just took into account just the visible subtools that we have. And now, go to each one of your high things here. So I'm going to turn Solo on here. Turn him off. So we want to export just as a regular OBJ. Export, save. Go to head high, export, save, ears high, export, save, and then our Greebel plane, export, save. And that's it. We are done pretty much inside ZBrush. I know this is a pretty lengthy tutorial, guys, and I'm sorry, but want to get all this out there for you to show you what you can do with everything. So, bear with me a minute, and we will jump inside Substance Painter and start there, okay? Alright, here we are in Substance Painter. First, we are going to set up our Greebel material. We're going to build him real quick and make him into a smart material that we can reuse over and over and over in other projects. So, Make document resolution 2048 by 2048. We're going to add. There we go. Here is all of our files that we created earlier. Open them up. So just add additional files. We're going to select, go back and get that Greeble plane. A 1K file there. Click OK. So this way we can see our material being built. So now all you got to do is just dump it all into these little selection boxes over here. So grab normal, put him in normal. Grab ambient occlusion, throw him in. You can see ID map, we need to throw ID in there. We need to throw in curvature. Let's see, who else do I need? Nobody else. We don't really need any of the others at the moment. So as we can see, we have already started to build the material. Already looks really cool. So what I want to do is take the shaded. We're going to change that layer 1 to add fill. And we just need a color material in here. And go ahead and drop your shaded into the base color. There you go. Now we got all our color information back. And it also has its own little ambient occlusion in there too. So it kind of helps sell the depth of the material. So let's go ahead. We want to actually, let's go ahead and add a height into this material, and we're going to go ahead and grab our depth and drop it in there. Really doesn't change a whole lot on the screen. You know, it's still a flat plane, but if we hit C and cycle through everything, you see here's your base color. There is our height. The height is going to be what's helping us drive our displacements in Marmoset. You can use whatever application you want that you use displacements in, 3D Max, Maya, Modo, even ZBrush, KeyShot doesn't do displacements, but there's a way that you can use in the KeyShot bridge out of ZBrush. You could take use a surface noise and use that depth map to generate it. But there's many applications that could do it. I'm just going to show Marmoset today because it's kind of quick and easy. So hit M to go back to your material here. As you can see, it looks nice and pretty. You can add a little roughness if you wanted to. Go ahead and add a roughness channel. Just to add some variation in there, we can go ahead and add this one here, as you can see, and now it's applied that roughness map in there. There we go. We can get that running over that, and it worked out pretty good. So let's say we want to have an emissive channel. So let's go ahead and add, see the channels there, go ahead and add emissive, and we're going to go ahead and add an opacity too, so we have a real cool Greeble here that can work in any situation that you want. So let's go ahead and we will go create a new layer. We're going to create a fill, but we're going to turn everything off but emissive. We could add uniform color, go up to red. I always like the kind of light blue, that always looks the best. To me, anyways, you can change the color as you see fit. It's not going to be over the whole thing. It's just going to be over whatever we select here. So let's go ahead and do add mask with color selection. There we go. Cleaned it up there a little bit. I'm going to zoom into our pipes here and pick a color. And as you can see, now we can choose our... Oops. Yeah, don't try to move the canvas or anything when you're doing a pick color. It only wants you to do that and nothing else. So pick color. Let's try our conduit here. And let's see how that looks. That's not bad at all. That will work for what we need. Let me see if I can quickly... Let me put him in a folder. Let's see if I can put him in a folder. Okay, no problems there. What I want to do is... Yeah, that's what I want to do. I want to add a paint layer to this. And just so I can... I'm going to change it to black. We're going to pick like a dirt brush. There it goes. All right. We're going to increase the scale a little bit here. We're going to... turn down the hardness, and I just want to go in here and break up some of that emission. And all I'm doing is just overriding the mask a little bit. Just break it up just a little bit so it doesn't look so perfect. Because that's the nice thing about Substance Painter. You can give it that realistic look. Because the only time anything is going to look pristine and perfect is... I guess in a car dealership. That's about it. So we don't want everything to be perfect. So, and I think we're just going to add... Maybe just a dirt layer over everything. And let me find a material. It doesn't have to be anything crazy. Maybe just uniform black will work. And we'll turn off. We'll just do a color here. The roughness helps out, helps sell it quite a bit. And then we'll just add a little bit of color variation here. Let's see, I want to make sure the hardness is down quite a bit. There we go. Just roughen everything up just a little bit. And kind of stay away from the edges. So when it overlaps, it doesn't, you don't see that little bit there. Looks like I did a little bit up there. There we go. Alright, so we dirtied up Agreeable. He's got a nice roughness and emissive, and we just have to give him a... I'm going to throw him on the bottom, an opacity. So go ahead and add a fill, and everything but, or everything turned off, but opacity all the way to white. And then, want to change our viewer settings real quick so we can see it. And that's PBR metal rough with alpha blending. I'm going to zoom in here. And then we'll create a top layer real quick. Same operation. Add a fill. Everything off but opacity. But change it to black. Everything's invisible. Add mask with color selection. Pick color. And pure black is going to be your alpha. And there you go. We can now see through our Agreeable. Well, we should be able to. Oh, I picked the metal. Sorry. Let me pick again. And always want to make sure you're zoomed in real close on that. And there you go. You now have opacity in your Agreeable. So you can put it on a crate, a wall, whatever, side of a building. So there you go. All right, so we need to export these textures out. So File, Export Textures, and let's find a folder that we can play with here. Let's see, make new folder, whatever you want to call it, just so you know where to go get it. Flexible material. And select folder. Keep the document size. We'll keep it as a PNG files. Has a lot less compression issues. And go ahead and export. And then we'll open it up and see how it did. Slowly but surely. There we go. All right, so there is our base color. There is our emissive. Oh, that's right. Okay. It has alpha. That's why it's didn't show black. Okay. So we should still be okay. Here is our height. And metallic. There's no metallic in there. It's fine. And then our opacity. And our material roughness. Okay. So we got everything necessary to make a material or a material inside Substance Painter. So let me close him. We'll save him. Save. In case we have to come back and make some changes, save them out. And we're going to do File New. Going to open up our cyborg that we created a little bit ago. So he's an FBX file. Double click him. Don't need to load any. Well, actually, we do need to load maps. We'll add that new one that we just made, Groovable Material. We will grab everything in there. Open. And click OK. It'll load up all the maps we need and our object here. And then we'll start putting them together. Alright, so let's go ahead and get the basics out of the way here. Let me drag him down. There we go. Here's our three material sets over in the upper right-hand corner. And if you click, they come in as 0, 0, 1, 0, 2. Unfortunately, they don't hold on to the name. Don't know why. Not sure if it's the FBX exporter out of ZBrush. But they load up just fine, like in Marmoset. So I'm not sure if it's something to do with the import process inside Substance Painter. So you pretty much just have to click them off and on to see which one they are. So there's our ears. There is the head. And then the bottom one would be the faceplate. So just kind of remember the order. So let's go ahead and start with the faceplate because that's the cool one. So let's go ahead. We need to go over to texture sets, and we need to bake our textures for him. We need to change him to 2048. We want to have everything on but thickness. We want to change our ID to mesh ID. Let's go back, click common again, and open up. Find him. There he is. And we're looking for the faceplate high right here. And change the frontal distance to click that little thing there, 0.05. Just change that if you're having artifacts with the bacon operation. You'll notice artifacts sometimes with your either something won't project out or your ambient occlusion comes out weird. Just increase that, where it's originally was 0.01, I just increase it up to 0.05. Don't go crazy trying to increase it. So it just projects it out a little bit further, so it'll remove any artifacts. So go ahead and click Bake Textures. I think we're set up for it. Give it just a second. Being only 2K, it bakes it pretty quick. And it'll it'll start populating the textures at the lower left there, as you can see. And then it'll plug them correctly over into here. And everybody came across perfectly. Projected quite nicely. I like it. Kind of looks like one of those, kind of reminds me of one of those masks from the Hispanic wrestlers. And then some in the WWE. Rey Mysterio, that's it. That's who I was thinking of when I saw this. So, yeah, just a side note, me just babbling. All right, so let's go ahead. We've got him fixed, so let's go ahead and go to, what's that one? That one's the head. So we're going to bake him. We need to get rid of that one that's in there already. We don't need an ID. And we don't need thickness again. And let's load up head high. Okay, we just keep everything else the same. And click bake. That'll just smooth everybody out a little bit. And then it'll map the world space and position maps for you. So this way everything will work, all your particles and stuff like that will work correctly. And let's fix our ears, bake its texture, and turn off thickness, turn off ID, we don't need that, and erase that one, open this, and ears high, and let's go ahead and bake him. There we go, I fixed him, he's almost done. Okay, good to go. We have the baking process all done. So we can go, we'll go mess with the faceplate first. So go back down to that material 2. And let's give him a materials. We'll use a smart material. I always go for this T800 metal, which you can download from just by clicking this here and signing in. It's the Substance Share website. So a lot of cool materials there for free. This one's a smart material. You just drag and drop it. Give it a second to process. There we go. Gives you that nice T800 Terminator look there. Sort of. So, but we're never done with just one texture. I always like to add one or two on top of it. So we'll drag a tire rubber right above it. It will fill it full real fast. That's all right. We'll fix that. Just right click mask with color selection. Now we're going to add our detail. Now we're going to have fun with that ID mask, and that's why we had to split the model up. And this is why you do that. Now you're able to get all these nice little material IDs to where you can start assigning new materials. So it's just go through and pick them. Pick the ones you want. Top here, pick a couple of these guys up here, pick him, now he's looking pretty cool, and let's see, who else do I really want to pick? I might as well pick him, and we're going to zoom in a little bit here. So I can get those little crevices there. There's a dark red right there. Bam. Okay. Zoom out. And we can click solo here so we can see the backside here. And pick another color. Pick that dark red. Bam. All right. He's looking pretty good right there. Okay. Let's add a little color to the front of it here. We can unsolo him for now. So, as you could tell, it only works on whatever material is selected here. So, whichever particular object you're on, it will only work on just that one. Alright, so continuing on here, let's add some little colored paint up front, like I did on that one I showed at the beginning of the video here. So, we're going to slap another material on here. And another one of my standby ones is this machinery smart material. We'll throw him on top. Takes him a second to generate. He's kind of complicated. But only a few seconds, really. So go ahead and add just a black mask. We're not going to use our ID for any of that. If you go up here, click these arrows right here. This is symmetry on the x-axis, and you can change which axis you're mirroring on. And then you can even change the symmetrical plane. You can actually turn that on or off. So we'll just keep it on for the time being, just so you can see what's going on here. So I'm selected on the mask there. I've got a white color, but we'll try this artistic one. And we'll increase his size here. And I may increase the hardness just a little bit. And if you click once, and then you hold your shift, see how it's dragging that line right there? And it's all based on camera space. And then click down, boom. Now you drew this nice little line down across everything, and you threw some paint on front of it. Kind of a cool little effect there. So let's go ahead and we could turn symmetry off. Because you remember we mapped this guy not to be symmetrical, which is always a good thing. So you can still mess with that mask even with the symmetry off now. We can change the color back to black, and I can change the hardness down, and I may change it to dirt 2. We can go in there, we can go in and remove some of that paint if you wanted. So if you didn't want all that paint all over everything, you can just come in and just manipulate the mask a little bit. Very cool. So, or you can switch it and you can go to add more paint. There you go. So, to kind of break up some of that symmetry there, because we're going to have plenty of symmetry once we put the greebles on the other one here. So, real quickly, I just want to put a quick, select that bottom layer. Want to put a little bit of dirt on everything. Let us do. Materials we want. We don't want a uniform black again. And we can play with our particles a little bit. You can come in and do rain, and it's going to use that uniform black there as the material. We're going to increase the size. You can see a preview of basically what it's going to do. And we just let it rain. Just a quick, easy way to add. As you can see, it's pooling up around our panel lines. You could come in, you can do leaks if you wanted. But I don't know, I'm not too worried about that. I kind of like it as is, just like that. So, we want to do one more thing. We want to add an emissive channel. So let's go up to channels, emissive, and we're going to do one more layer. I'm going to create a fill. I'm We are going to turn everything off but emission. Change it all the way up. Go to our middle of the blue here. We are going to add a black mask. Zoom in real close here. And get my brush back to normal. There we go. And go to geometry decal right there. Set it to UV. It's on white. And we click just that intersect. Boom. There we go. That's why I wanted to leave that little UV sliver right there. That's why we got those separate poly groups. And I got to do it on this side too. There we go. And it'll put a little glow around the eyes there once we get it into Marmoset. It doesn't really show that well inside here, but that's all right. So we can go back to the standard brush and call it a wraps on the faceplate there. And make sure I am on him. Okay. So I'm going to solo him so we can get a better view of what's going on here. Because we are going to set up our smart material. Okay, so double click that. Greeble material. Okay. And you have to make sure you're setting everything up in a folder. That's how smart materials work. They're just all set up in a folder. So all you have to do is add a, let's change it. We don't need an opacity for this one. Actually, we want an opacity. And we also want emissive. All right, so now let's set up a fill. I don't know who this fill guy is, but still. All right, so let's go ahead and open up. We got our textures here. Need to go down and find all our Greeble ones that we put together. So let's find, see the emissive. Put him in there. Okay, he's working. As just drag and drop, find all those materials you made earlier. And roughness here. Okay. Opacity. And we need to find our base color. There he is. Base color. And then get down to metallic. Even though we don't. All right, so there is our basic Greeble material. But we've got a lot of options to play with here. So go to your fill here. You're still in there. Actually, before we do anything else, before we start altering anything in here, right click and create smart material. And it should have already put one in there. And it always puts it in alphabetical order. I just gotta find it. Eesh. Oh, I'm getting close now. Oh, smart materials. I wonder I can't find it. And, oop. There it is. Greeble material. Boom. So go ahead and hit C. There's your base color. There is your height. Boom. See, this is what we're going to make our displacement with later. Okay, so we've made our smart material that we can use anywhere now. Now I'm going to show you how to manipulate it. So hit M to get out of there. Let's turn the faceplate back on. So we can see how he looks in comparison to the faceplate. Let's see here. Open him up. Go to your fill. And you've got options of messing with the UV scale and the UV offset and the rotation. You really don't need rotation because the way this thing is mapped, I'll show you. If you go click 2D, boom, you can see how it's mapped. Remember how we did a mirror and weld? So it's mirrored on both sides. So that's why you got this big blank in the center here, because it's not using up all the texture. But if it was, it would be a perfect square. And that's what I like about those primitives inside ZBrush. They have perfect square textures when you use them. So it uses a lot of the texture space. So let's go back to 3D, and we'll manipulate our Greeble real quick. So UV scale, you can scale them up. And you can see all the fun, exciting things that you can do with this. And what I want to do is I want to find, by using the offset, I want to find something going horizontally across that those eyes there. That's how I created that one earlier. Trick is just finding the right spot in the texture. That's kind of cool. I like that mouthpiece down there. Dang. Alright, so let's see here. See, so if I expand those out, you can actually turn off it locks the scale horizontally and vertically, and you can alter each one individually. Getting close. Wish I had like a little gimbal or something in here I could mess with. That'd be kind of cool. Let me see. Oh, we're almost there. There we go. That'll work. No one says you have to do that. It just looks cool. So let's see how the rest of it looks. Got a lot of detail all over the place. Yeah, I like that with the pipes going right there. Cool. All right, so let's go on to our earmuffs here. Let's put them together. So basically, all you got to do now is find your Greeble material, drag and drop. Now the only thing is, he's not set up with an emissive. But boom, it's turned on now. And same thing, you can go in there and you can manipulate it. The only thing to remember, because this one's using a spherical map, is just make sure you keep your numbers at ones and twos, no decimals like it is right now. So basically, I want it to be a 2. But I can always go in and I can change him to, say, like 3. So this way, when I start offsetting, everything looks correct. Because if I did, let me put in 1.9, I'll show you. You'll start seeing a seam in here. It's kind of hard to notice, but there's a seam like right here. And that's because I got that 1.9 in there. But if I do it at a 2, everything should be good. Now it's seamless. But I can rotate things around or offset things to get the pattern that I like quickly and easily. But yeah, that is pretty much it. I mean, I can go in and I can add real quick, go up top here. I can add, you know, that particles again. Go to materials, find that uniform black. Uniform black. And let's see. See how this works here. Oh, wait. We want to be on rain. Zoom in a little bit. Sometimes it works, sometimes particles don't work. They don't always work on symmetrical maps. I don't know. Let me see if it's actually doing anything. Yeah, it did. It's just real faint. I need to increase the size. Now let's try this. There it goes. That's a lot better. So let's go to our head itself, and we will create a new layer, put him up top, and do the same thing. Add a little bit of weathering all over the place. I may just do some hand brushing here. Let's just do dirt. The size. I'm going to just do an X symmetry so I don't have to do this on both sides. Oh, I shouldn't have to. It's mirrored anyway, so I guess it doesn't really matter. And let's see. Let's just see how this works. There we go. Just kind of get it right around the edge there. Just kind of break up the two devices. Edge of the mask a bit. Pretty cool. Not too bad. Granted, it was a little longer tutorial than you guys are probably used to, for me anyways, but didn't really want to break up the tutorial that much. So, okay, so we've got everything put together. I'm going to go ahead and save him out. Save. I already did one earlier. I'll just do two. Save. Okay. Now we just... Gotta wait for it to save. There we go. Now let's export our textures. Alright. It's gonna have a texture for everybody here. We'll do ping 16-bit here. Export. Let's see, where's that cyborg? I just did one earlier. Cyborg head. Let me do 02. Okay. Select folder and export, and we're just doing document channels and normals, and then we'll open it up and make sure we got all the textures we needed. Give it a few seconds or so, and it'll be done processing. All right, let's open her up. Let's make sure we got everything we needed here. Alright, so this is material 0. And it's got a submissive, height, metallic, roughness. And with that greeble material, you can actually set up a metallic layer to it. I just didn't want to waste your time with it. So you can definitely go back and do that. I should have done it for you, but it's all right. Sake of time here. Okay, we are good. So I'm going to keep him opened up here. We'll keep that little folder opened up there. And I'm going to save him one more time. And I'm going to pause this, and I'm going to open it up in Marmoset, and we're going to finish this up, okay, guys? All right, guys, here we are inside Marmoset. I've got version 2.08. That's their latest version. And I'm going to minimize him just a little bit, or not minimize, but I'm going to make it to where I can have multiple windows open at the same time, because it's pretty much a drag and drop operation, really. So go find your original Cyborg FBX and drag and drop him into the center there. There he is loaded all up. And as you can see, we got several different groups, which is good. That's what we want. And now I can close him. And I still got our material set up in here. And as you can see, it's only got one material right now. We're going to have to make up a couple of them here. Let me zoom out just a hair. Alright, so let's go ahead and duplicate. And instead of naming them head and faceplate, I'm going to name them as they are over here, just so I don't get too lost on dealing with three different texture sets, I mean. So we got it 0, and we got to change him to 1. 01, okay. And then change him. 2. Alright. So, and it's still in the order of over here, so material 1 goes to the ears. Or material 0, material 1 goes to the head, and material 2 goes to the faceplate. Alright, now that we got all that out of the way, let's go to the faceplate one here, because that's the most front one here for us to look at. So I need to do material 2, and let's go ahead and drop our base color into albedo. Let's change our specular to metalness, and we will find our, where is, it didn't make a metal, yeah it did, there it is, and put that right there, there you go, change that to metalness, but you gotta change that to GGX, alright. That's how it works in here. Let's add our roughness to the microsurface. Add our normal to the normal. There we go. That fixes all that. Let's go ahead and add our emissive. And emissive. There you go. You can see them right there on the edges there. We can increase the intensity a little bit. Alright, so let's go to material 1. Let's start dragging and dropping them in here. So, let me find them. Where do I start? Alright, so base color, albedo. Same process again. Let's go emissive. I gotta open up emissive. Okay. Emissive. Perfect. Let's go to metalness and GGX and change the metal to there. Okay. Let us drop in our roughness. Rough. Okay. let us drop in our normal map. Alright. And then I'll come back to the displacements here in a second once I get the rest of the materials plugged in. So base color, albedo, change to metalness, GGX. It gets a little tedious after a while doing that. Emissive. Emissive. There we go. Let's see. Metal. Let's change. What am I missing here? Normal map. Normal. Okay. Let us change. What do I want? What am I missing? Microservice. I need roughness. Sorry, guys. It's late at night. Been looking at this stuff for a while. All day, actually. Alright, so we have got everything in there. So I'm going to plug in a displacement. Height. This is for material 0. So we grab the material 0 height. It's going to be way out of whack there. So I'm just going to lower him way down. And we'll do some fine-tuning here in a second. Let's go to material 1. We need to plug in a height map for him. And just got to go find him. There he is. And he's way out of sorts, too. So we will fine-tune him here in a second. I just want to make sure all my maps are plugged in. And that's it. That's all we need. So now we can zoom in and see what we're doing here. Alright, so let's take a look at our displacement maps here. So I am on the head, so let's go and we need to add some subdivisions. I just use flat, and I usually change it to about 1,000. Now you will start hearing your graphics cards start to hum, as I am right now. So. And you can see there's already a slight displacement there. You got to be very gentle with this displacement. It can blow it way out of proportions. But as you can see, especially up here, you can see it's protruding out even along here. When we get some better lighting going on here, you'll see it a lot better. So let's go to 0, which is our ears. Let's activate the subdivision. Change him up to about 1,000. Alright. Now we can scale him up just a hair if we wanted. There you go. You can really see it on him. Really adds a lot of dimension to it. That displacement map works beautifully. You can get a lot of detail on something really fast using this method. Alright, so let's go ahead and we're going to go ahead and I may go down to the emissive there, crank him up a little bit. There we go. Let's go to the material 1 and crank him up. Yeah, nice and bright, nice and bright. We like that. Alright, so let's go ahead and fix our lighting in our scene. I clicked on render, but actually you can activate the local reflections. Now you can see your emissive is shining onto other objects. You can do ambient occlusion, which helps out quite a bit. And that's just a screen-based ambient occlusion. Adds a lot to it. You can do some high-res shadows. And the more of these things you click on, the more your graphics card is going to cook. So make sure you got a halfway decent one and that you're up to date. Mine's several years old, so it's cooking pretty good right now. So let's change our scene. We're going to change our sky. I like to use... I get... Not right out of the box, but this evening construction... It's actually kind of neat. Okay, so it starts off dark. So it really shows off the emissive channel. But if you click on the little picture over here, this is your light editor. you can add lights just by clicking. You can click and drag. Click on one of these blue ones here. You can get some nice little rim lights going on here. Sometimes they turn out good, sometimes, nah, not so much. Sometimes you gotta do a little more tweaking. Oh, that's nice. Right there. Cool. Alright, so you can even manipulate them even more. So you can click on each individual skylight, and you can drag him out, and you can actually turn him into, instead of directional, you can change him into a spotlight, and I just need to turn him around, so he's actually facing the object. And totally lost him here. There he is. May have to zoom out so you can. There you go. So let's mess with the second one here. Let's change him to a spotlight. Get some better shadows there. Right there. There we go. And you can actually increase the brightness if you wanted. And let me mess with the last one here. Change him to a spot. You don't have to change him to spotlights. I just like to. Because you get better shadows, in my opinion. Alright, let me zoom back in. We've got our lights set up nice and neat. You can always do, I think, shift. Yeah, shift, and you can rotate the lights around till you get a better... You get a better one here. If you hold down Alt, you can, and left click, you can move everybody around. So let me go back to the main camera here. And you can also, you can add a little bit of a flare in there. You can definitely, bloom is always good. Just don't go crazy with it. Vignette definitely adds a lot to your scene. Just make sure you kind of mess with the softness a little bit. But yeah, you got you can do focus and all that. I'm not going to do focus because that's really going to get my GPU going here while I'm trying to record at the same time. But yeah, you can render this out. Your render options are up here. Your settings here, capture settings. You can change the width and all that. I usually do a frame rate of 180. And if you kind of want a preview on how it's going to look, usually I'll just plug in like a number 30 in the animation tab. On scene turntable, and then you can just click play, and it'll kind of give you an idea of what it's going to look like. And then you just tap your spacebar, and give you a full screen view. And you can rotate your model around, check him out, see how he's going to look in the final render. You can change some of the sampling, so it samples like 25 times or something like that, so you get a really clean render. You can render it out to 4K, you know, so there's plenty of little options here in Marmoset. But that's not your only choice for doing displacements. Like I said, Maya, Modo, all of them can do it. ZBrush, you can take it back into ZBrush and displace it there, send it over to KeyShot. So you got quite a few ways to do things, but this was just kind of a quicker way to show you. So hope you got something out of this video. Had fun making it. Very interesting to see what you guys are creating out there. Get back to me. Definitely want to showcase everybody's works off eventually. Once we start creating some things. I've seen some cool things done with the Greebles already. So definitely keep it up. Send them to me. I want to see them, and I'm sure a lot of other people would too. So thanks for stopping by again, and I will see you in the next video.